Welcome everybody to my hair fiber tips, tricks, hacks, and advice video. We're gonna get right into this video with the first piece of advice that I have. And I think the number one hair fiber out there is Topic. Topic hair fibers, they've been around for a long time. They're veterans in the game. They have all kinds of different colors. I mean, they have brown, they have light brown, dark brown, black, gray, white, light blonde, dark blonde. They have all the colors in the spectrum, so it could match a lot better to your hair color. I get the dark black because after I use gel, my hair pretty much turns jet black. So I use the black versus using the dark brown. I have a lot of people telling me, hey, doesn't the black look fake? Well, I believe that the dark brown and the black, they're really similar. I could only notice just a little bit, and I'm gonna show you guys this test right now on the screen. You guys could judge for yourself, but I just think that the dark brown is just a smidge off of the black color. But medium brown is definitely a lot lighter. So depending on what hair color you are, make sure you match it. And that's another thing I wanna talk about is you could pop the top on the Topic hair fiber cap and you could actually mix and match. That way you could match your hair color even more. So you could get the gray, you could get the salt and pepper, you could mix it. That way it matches your hair a little bit better than what they have going on. Another reason why I think Topic is number one is because they came out with the pump spray first, and I use the pump spray for my beard versus the top of the head. I just go on the top of the head and let gravity do its thing, and I just pour it kind of on top like so. But they do have the pump spray, and there are other companies that came out with it, but they all copied Topic, so you know, you choose which one you want to go with. One of the other questions I get is on Kabuki hair fiber. And if you guys didn't know, I have a couple other hair fiber tip videos. You can find them in the description box below. But back on Kabuki, yes, I have tried it, but I think that it's more on the expensive side. The cool thing about Kabuki is you could get a sample. So what I did is I ordered the sample. It's a nice little jar that you get. And what I found out about it is I think that the hair fibers, they're a little bit thicker than what I like. Like, I prefer the Topic hair fibers. It's the right size. I think Kabuki is a little bit too thick. So when you pour it on, I think you could, you know, get way too much on, especially if you're a beginner and you haven't used any hair fiber products before. This next tip is very important, especially if you use gel or any hair products. So after using the gel, you wanna make sure your hair is 100% dry before you apply any type of hair fiber. So if you do not wait till your hair is dry, your hair actually becomes more of a magnet when it's wet. And the point of any hair fiber is to get it all the way down to your scalp. So some people think that you're supposed to attach it to your existing hair, like on the top, but no, that is incorrect. What you wanna do is you wanna make it go all the way down into the scalp, and that gives you the full set of hair look. Okay, so if it's wet, it makes it stick like a magnet. Trust me on this one, you guys. You want your hair 100% dry before you apply any type of hair fiber. Another question I get a lot is how long does the hair fiber last? And it all depends on what size you have. Like for Topic, they have the small, medium, and large bottles. Also, it depends on the amount, how much you're using. So if you're thinning out like me, I say a medium bottle of Topic could last me anywhere from 2 months to 3 months easily. I wanna let you guys know that I am not sponsored, hashtag not sponsored. All the stuff that I'm telling you guys is the stuff that I purchased with my own money, and this is my personal opinion. Topic did not reach out to me to tell me to do this video. I'm doing this video because I stand by the product. If you guys wanna buy any products in this video or any of my other videos, head down to the description box and the show more. You go down to my gear and products. I have a list of all kinds of things you guys could get in there, check it out. But I am not sponsored by Topic or Kabuki or any product that I'm mentioning in this video. The next tip is a money saving tip, so this one is very important. Okay, I recently came across, recently I mean 1 month ago, I came across the Jar God brand hair fiber. And what I bought is I bought the 100 gram bag, and it costs only $16, if you could believe that. And what it is, it's a refill. So the good thing about Topic is you could pop the top on it, and then you could get the Jar God hair fiber, and you just pour it inside there, and you kind of reuse the Topic bottle. But the thing is, now you have a more of a refill, and it's 100 grams. That's gonna last you a long time. So that's a good money-saving tip. I've been using it for a month, and I think the hair fibers are a little bit bigger than Topic, but they are definitely smaller than the Kabuki big hair fibers. So they're right in the middle, and I wanna know, have you guys bought this, and have you guys ever tried this? Please, I wanna know in the comment box below. Another comment that I see a lot are people saying, oh yeah, you could apply hair fiber on people, but you can't do it to yourself. Actually, I have a tip for you guys, and it's for the back of the head. All you do is you grab your mirror and you stand in front of another mirror, and that's gonna help you see the back of your head. So once you're looking through the mirror, you gotta kinda go in reverse. So pay attention to what you're doing. It takes a lot of practice. Yes, it is hard in the beginning, but if you guys wanna put the hair Topic fiber all the way in the back of your head, this is the way to do it. So one of the tricks I use to get that crisp line right here, I know not everybody has my haircut, not everybody could be cool like me, okay? But no, just joking around, but seriously, if you guys wanna get that crisp line, I use a piece of cardboard. In this case, it's Lucky Charms, but doesn't matter what it is, just grab a cardboard, you cut it out, and what I do is I put it on my head, and then it kinda acts like a guideline. So I put the Topic on, I sprinkle it on, you guys know I call it pepper sometimes, so I sprinkle on the pepper, and then it makes that crisp line once I remove the cardboard. And other people, they like using tape. I've seen other videos that they use tape, but what I use is cardboard, and I also use my hand sometimes. So when I don't need a straight line and I need it kind of curving, that's when I put my hand up and then sprinkle the pepper on, and then I'm good to go. So one of the cons about using the spray pump is that it gets everywhere. So yes, it is messy, but like I said, I do like using it on my beard. And I'm showing you guys this demo right now, and it only took 15 seconds, believe it or not. So it is pretty quick, and it's nice, crisp line, and it just looks nice and thick. If you guys wanna see me how I grew my beard, because it didn't always look this thick, check out this video in the description box below. It shows how I grew my beard with minoxidil. I have a super hack for you, and that's using pomade. So I have a couple different brands that I use for pomade, but what you do is you grab a little bit on your fingers and then you put it on your head where you're gonna apply the fibers to. Okay, in my case, I applied it to my beard and it sticks like a charm. You just want to use a very, very minor, tiny little bit. Don't wanna get crazy with it. Just use a little bit and the hair fibers are gonna stick right on it. So if you're having issues with hair fiber sticking on your head or on your beard, just use a little bit of pomade. It goes a long way. Another trick, if you want to get the hair fiber on nice and even, you want to make sure you hold it parallel to your head. I know sometimes I mess up and I kind of tilt it sideways, and when you tilt it sideways, too much goes in one area and that looks fake, it looks whack. Do not do that. Make sure you have it nice and flat, that way it's going down at an even level and everything looks nicer and flatter that way. Another thing I want to talk about, I don't know if you guys noticed or not, please tell me in the comments below, but have you ever noticed when you put the hair fiber on and you have a little bit of sweat and it kind of turns green? Well, that's because Topic or any other hair fibers, they use a color dye. And so when that color dye gets wet, unfortunately it turns green and you're gonna see it. I sometimes see it in the sink. My wife gets mad at me, but you know, I try to clean it up and make it look nice. But I want you guys to know that it does turn green. So be careful if you're wearing a white shirt. Be careful if it's raining or drizzling or you got moisture outside, because Topic does turn green. Speaking of drizzle and rain, one of the number one questions I get is hair fiber waterproof? And sorry, but no, it is not waterproof. You can make it water resistant, And one of the ways to do that is use the pomade that I told you guys about, because the pomade gets in the skin, gets the hair fiber on there, and it makes it stick to your skin better. So if there's any moisture or if it rains a little bit, you're gonna actually be okay if you have that pomade on there. Or you got the locking fiber spray that from Topic, you could use that, and that actually smells pretty good. And so what you do is after you put the fiber on, you spray it and it locks it to your skin the same way pomade does. But like I said, it is water resistant, not waterproof. If it rains, you better head somewhere that the rain is not getting to your head, or just grab an umbrella. And another thing is, you do not have to have the Topic spray. You could actually use hairspray. I use Aquanet. People ask me what I use, so I use Aquanet, but you guys could use any hairspray that you want. Since we're talking about rain, I wanted to talk about wind. So unless you live in Chicago, Chi-Town, where it's crazy windy, the wind does not affect Topic. A little bit of wind is gonna be okay, but I'm telling you, if you live somewhere like Chicago, you better be careful, because if it's a strong gust of wind, it'll blow off a little bit of Topic, but nothing crazy. And since it's not wet, it's not gonna get green or any of that good stuff, so you do not have to worry about wind. This next one is a travel hack, and this one is very important, especially if you're gonna bring your hair fiber with you. I just grab a little bit of tape. I use painter's tape. You could use duct tape. So I just use a little bit of tape on top of the bottle, and that actually covers it, so you're not messing around and getting everything messy in your luggage or in your bags. So that's just a quick travel hack. Hope you guys like that one. Let me know if you've used it before or if you plan on using it in the future. It is time for the question of the day. I want to know which hair fiber you guys use, and I want to know why. So please put that in the comment box below. Thank you guys so much for checking out this video. It means a lot to me that you guys made it all the way to the end. If you got some good information, hit that like button. Comment down below if you have any questions or suggestions for me. Subscribe, and I will check you guys out on the next video.